Hey, good morning. A very good morning to everybody. And I am waiting for my friends to join in for this beautiful topic of how many children to have. So let's wait. Hey, everybody, good morning. Many, many people already joined in. Could you please say a quick hi? And whether you're married, not married, thinking of having children, how many? So put in your comments for me to know that you're there. And what are your thoughts? What are your questions for today? And let's bring it on a Sunday morning. And hey, Ronak, good morning. Hi, Tarun. A very good morning to everybody. Happy to see you here. Okay. And the notifications are still coming in. People are still joining in. Fabulous. More and more people. Hey, Rajpuntala. Hey, Nitin. Good morning. Good to see you here. So are you guys like thinking about having children? Or what is it going? What's your thought? What's happening? Also, let me know how many years married you are. Not married yet, Tarun? Yeah, good discussion to have before marriage, right? More clarity. Fabulous. Hey, Vidya. Hey, Manish. Thank you, Vidya. I'm glad to see you all guys here early morning. Hey, Fahed. Abdul. Okay, Nitin. You are also unmarried here. That's awesome to see, yeah, that you guys are interested in these topics. It's going to be so clearer when you are married and when you're taking decisions. Fabulous. Hi, Raja. Good morning. Okay, so I've waited for a while and I'm sure more and more people are going to join in. So let me start this topic with this crucial question most of us parents have in today's time specifically. How many children to have? Now, many of you might know and might know people in, you know, in your circles, in your family. At least I knew one dadi, like a grandmom, my friend's grandmom, who had 16 children. 16 children. Now, 16 children is unthinkable in today's times. You have to have all the resources and everything has to be there to be able to raise so many children. Ronak already is saying, and I am married for 2 years. My wife is age 28. What is the right age to plan kids? So Ronak, how old are you too? And you know, you guys are in fabulous age to start having children. Ronak, was your marriage a love marriage or an arranged marriage? Do specify that too. So I know how long you've been with each other and whether you know each other well, if your compatibility level is, you know, fabulous and great. So I think it's a fabulous age and 2 years into marriage. Yeah, I think you guys are ready. Absolutely. You can start planning your family. That's what I wanted to go through, some pointers of how do we decide how many children to have. See, in today's times, I know most of us, especially the urban cities where everything's expensive, we are in, you know, a short of time. What we decide is two. And many, I still have friends who've gone in for 3 children, and most of us look at her as if she's won a war, you know, like 3 kids. Are you kidding me? Are you serious? I mean, hats off to you to have the patience and the, you know, capacity to raise 3 children. Because today's children are not the same what we were, obviously. And we are not the same parents what our parents were. So we are more of those helicopter parents where we want to know everything about our children. We want to be there for them. And it's physically and sometimes, you know, for different reasons, not possible. We also want to work. We also want to take care of our nuclear families. It's just become too much for us as an individual. So yes, you know, you have to have certain factors in place to be able to make this decision. So the first thing I would like to say is, since Ronak already put this question, Ronak, look into what you and your wife as a couple decide. So look into what are the factors you both are talking about, whether you as a couple is ready to have children, right? Ready as in sense, we'll talk about those points too. So first you talk it out. How many children do you want to have? Now, since you're still planning to start a family, go for it at least, you know, for the first one. And then, but it's a good time to talk before you go for the first one as to how many children you both are looking into. And then take it forward further from there. The second point, usually what we talk about is the age of the woman, age and health, both ways. So it is observed and it is said, the researchers say, that the best time to have children is the age between 20 and 35 for the woman. So if you are falling under this age and you can have two children at least within this age, it'll be the best health-wise for you and for the child, both. So it is also said, whether it's a, see, the woman also has certain changes in her bodies, which she will be, you know, starting after the age of 35, 40 in today's times, where her physical capacity, her physical health and age does affect having children. Not that you cannot, you definitely can, but there is a risk involved, you know, after the age of 35. So if you are falling between the age of 20 and 35, I think you should absolutely go in for it and start planning, or have the second or the third child if you want to have, and but keep the age and the health factor in mind. Andrea says, my father has 12 more siblings. See, we know so many families who have more than 10 and 15 children, and that setup is completely different. There's a different kind of bonding. There's a different kind of, you know, fun involved in these kind of families. But that was then. Ronak says, it was a love marriage and they were in a relationship since 8 years. So Ronak, I think you are pretty, you know your wife. Your wife knows you. You've spent time with each other. Already 2 years into marriage. So I'm hoping she's already comfortable in the home setup, in the married life setup, because it's very different to be in love and to be in a relationship where you're not living together and now living in. And if you're living in with your, as a joint family, it's another setup altogether. So you've graduated from being a girlfriend, boyfriend, to then being husband and wife, to then living in a setup where there are other people involved in your lives now. So if everything is in place, please, this is a good time to start your family. And if you are looking into having a second child, have it before she turns 35. So that brings in a lot of health, positivity to that. Raja says he's also unmarried. Of course, you should see the live show, Raja. Whether you're married or not unmarried, knowledge never goes waste, and it's going to help you further on to be able to take decisions. And maybe when you're talking to your to-be wife, this could be one point to discuss in case your desires or your wishes are more than having more than two children. So definitely you should watch any show for that matter. And I'm happy to see all the unmarried people here. As I mentioned earlier, it's good to have all this knowledge before. So most welcome, Raja. I'm happy to have you here. So that was one factor that we spoke about. One is to discuss as couples. Two is to keep in mind your wife's age and health. Look into the medical health of your wife too. In case there are any other medical issues or health-wise there are issues, make sure you've spoken to your doctor. Make sure your gynecologist know about her health status. And from there you take it forward. if there is any medical health or any health concerns, I would suggest please visit your family doctor, visit your gynecologist, let them know what the scenario is like, and then take a call under their supervision with their advice. So please make sure that that angle is taken care of. Okay. The third point is to understand your age and health. Now, it is true that women will stop, ovulating after the age of 45, 50, but men can still father their, father children till he dies. That means his production of sperm does not stop. Women will stop, ovulating. That is, their eggs do not leave the ovaries now and come to the uterus for the production of, let me use terms that you can understand, so that she can have a baby. But a man definitely produces sperms till he dies. Sperms are the cells which are responsible for the baby making, right? So he still produces these sperms till he dies. So he can father a child even at his old age. But there is an angle to it. There definitely is an angle where his sperm count will come down. You have to understand the reproductive system to understand this. So sperms are produced in the testes, which then go to a seminal vesicle. There's an organ which produces the semen, which is a liquid, the whitish liquid. Now, when the sperm is in the semen, there are a number of sperms which are produced every minute for a man. He produces millions and millions of sperms, okay? But now these millions, which is almost like 170 million sperms, comes down to 35 million sperms. Now, if a healthy man produces 170 million sperms, to then, have sex and the sperms are reaching out to the egg in the fallopian tubes of the woman, only one sperm wins. So out of those million sperms, one sperm wins. So the count has gone down when the man ages, 50 years and above. Your age, your medical health does matter as a man too. So if you are looking into having children at an older age, are you sure you can run behind the child? Are you sure physically you are fit to raise a child? Because raising a child just does not mean providing the best of the homes and the best of the food and the best of the clothes. It also means playing with your children. It means mentally, physically being there. And it can get exhaustive, especially if you're looking to have more than two and three children. You know, having the noise around the house, having the energy around the house, to be able to provide for them, to be able to go to schools for them, to be able to run around for the classes for them, to send them here and send. There's a lot involved, in raising children in today's times. So your health and your age also will be a big factor in deciding whether to have one child, two children, three or more. So that is a bigger factor to look into. Abhishek is saying that I think none, Earth is overloaded. So Abhishek, yes, India and China are overloaded, but there are places where they are wanting more children because the population is going down. So maybe we could do some adjustments here. Some of us can go there, but not everywhere the Earth is overloaded. And Earth is huge, nature is huge. It has place for everybody. Just that we need to respect it, right? So Abhishek, think about it, whenever you want to. So that's about the questions right now. My next topic, my next pointer is the resources that you have, your finances. Are you capable? Are you okay to raise your children in today's time and age, wherever you're staying, whether your finances can be taken, are they enough to take care of the children? So we, as parents, we want to give the best to our kids. As kids being raised in the society around, sometimes there could be times when the child is asking for more, whether it is not just food and the restaurants and the clothes they are wearing. Maybe it's the career they are choosing. Today's education is also getting a little expensive, especially in the urban cities, whether our resources are monetary resources are enough to be raising children in healthy atmospheres. So keep that in mind, whether you are okay to spend whatever money you've spent on your first child and your second. Are you okay and do you have the resources to spend that kind of money for your third or the fourth or the fifth child? Now, resources also mean people to take care of your children. Now, one human being, whether it's a father or the mother who's staying in the house and taking care of children, it's practically and it's impossible for one person to be there mentally and physically for children 24/7. The person is drained out within 2 hours of staying with children. That's the observed time. Within 2 hours, a person feels a little tired and exhausted. This is on a general note that I'm saying. And they want a change. Now, if you have more than 2 and 3 children, think about the resources, the people who can support you. Yes, they could be in schools for 8 to 3, but after that, what? To be able to healthily raise your child, to be able to mentally and emotionally be present for your child. See, our parents, there was no emotional angle, as in, not that they were not emotional for us, but they were not there. Okay, they did not know little things about us. Now, there are pros and cons to knowing little things, but please understand where I'm coming from. Today, we have recognized a lot of things that have gone wrong for us, or we would have expected our parents to be there for us, and they could not because they were trying to make ends meet. They were trying to take care of so many children, plus the household, plus the social life they had. So you have to be sure of where you are and whether you can take care of all of that. And in today's times, our social life, our me time, our couple time, all that has been included in that 24 hours, earlier that our parents used to have and now we have. So they still had joint families. All the children were raised together by somebody or the other. Today, most of the families are going nuclear. And even there are joint families I have known as a counselor. We still are responsible for our own children. We are just living under the same roof. So please make sure that you have people to support you. You have your resources, whether it's financial or emotional, present there. You are not alone trying to, take care of everything by yourself. It's unhealthy for a person. And I have known parents going under depression because they can't manage. So times have changed. We are not as courageous and physically ready to be taking on such a challenge to have more than 3 children. And in today's times, lot of people connect through social gatherings and having a social life. Family life is going low, so you will not be able to be present everywhere. So imagine having 4, 4, 5, 5 children and to be able to be at all the open days, to be there at the birthday parties, and to be there at the dinners that are happening, and to be there for your children to do the homework. You make them sit in a line. It's not the ideal situation that we are talking about here, where all your children are going to sit nicely and listen to you and do their homework. So there's a lot involved in having a lot of children. So keep these factors in mind before you decide of having children. And maybe today you have those resources, but make sure that are you going to have them for a longer period of time. So I might have help at home today, but what if she leaves me tomorrow? Am I okay to do that? Am I going to get a help? Today, frankly, I do not have help at home, and I am managing the house, the kids, my work, everything. Like, you have to have that courage. You have to be up there and wanting to do that with a smile on your face. That's important. So make sure that that is taken care of. Another big factor is the temperament of your marriage. Temperament of your marriage, as in how healthy your marriage is. whether you and your husband are on the same, whether you as a wife or the husband and the wife are on the same page, and you both are not undergoing a lot of emotional stress. So please make sure that your marriage is healthy and then decide to have more children. That is also important, okay? Having kids can result in louder houses, chaotic houses, a house that is not tidy. So you have to be, I can also describe all of this as fun. So it depends on how you as a couple see the future to have so many children. So it is important to speak about all this before deciding, and it's not just a decision somebody has taken out of a desire or out of a wish. It is important to counsel. It's important to speak to your friends and family of how their lives is. But remember, it's not necessary how their life is how your life is going to be. But certain things are very common, like having an untidy house, having the sweet chirpy noises around, and the same children when they grow up to be teenagers to have those rolling eyes around you. So once you are a parent forever. So it is important to know what goes into being a parent and what goes into having so many children, or even to have two children for that matter, and then decide whether you're up to it or no. Sometimes it may sound scary, but you have to have a gut feeling for that. Like for me, having the second child was being courageous. So many of my friends would be like, you are mad, you have two children. But I think I could have been fabulous with four too, you know, having four children. So it is a choice you make in spite of the world scaring you that how are you going to do this and are you going to be able to do that. I think the love for children would have made me just do it. The fact of having the kids in my house and having that house full of happiness would have made me do it. So it's a choice you will make as an individual. It's a choice you will make as a couple. So that is what I'm saying, that it's important to know how healthy your marriage is for you to know that you can do this together. Okay, so that is another important point you need to consider. The unknown factor is what I talk about when I say the gut feeling. So your gut is of extreme importance to know whether you want to or you don't. But now there is an angle here. Imagine when you just married, like one of our viewers here, you've been married you've been married for 2 years, you know each other. Now there is something called society pressure. Your parents, your in-laws, your friends, your families, your society as a whole will start asking you questions. So now, when are you going to have children? So how many children do you want? You have to have two children. It's very important for the healthy growth of your first child. So understand this. The first child usually is a biological call. Or the society pressure that it's 2 years now, you have to have children. Or it's a biology call that, you know what, I'm settled in my marriage. And it is a conditioning. Of course, it's a conditioning from all these years. And now I want to have a child. Now, when you take a decision based on your biological needs and the societal pressure, you might end up having one child. Then you start realizing what goes into having a child. How the sleepless nights could be fun or could be the other way around. How your health is taking a toll on you. How your emotional and your mental state of health is. So many women undergo depression after they are pregnant, after the childbirth. It's not funny. And if you are not in that state of mind to be able to take care of yourself, you need to understand that further on, it's going to be the similar kind of a state. You have to just be educated enough to know what you are going to be facing, or what you're going to be, what choices you're making. So the first child is usually a biological call or the societal pressure. The second child is usually a call you make based on this decision that my first child needs a sibling. 99% of the parents who've gone in for their second child has always had the thought that family to complete hona chahiye. My older child has to have a sibling, a company, and that is where you decide for your second child. The third child, most of the cases I have seen or read or known about, could be because of the gender of the child. You have two boys, you want a third girl. You have two girls, you want a third boy. It could be there. So these are the observations and these are the known factors we've had. Very few families actually go in to say, no, I just love children and I want a big family. So understand your reasoning, know why you're deciding to have children, whether it's one, two, or three, or more. And make sure that all these discussions that, you know, the pointers that I'm putting in forward in front of you today are taken care of. Please speak within your family to discuss it out. But first, it's your individual choice. Second, it's your couple choice. Then speak to friends and family just to get a feel of how different families are raising their children and how you can do best. The more you and your spouse are connected, the more easier it will become to take this decision because you both are in it together. It's something that you've decided as a couple in a relationship. And when you both are responsible in it, you will never feel alone, even if the circumstances are not the same as before. You both will be in it, right? So make sure that you've gone through these pointers, read about it, talk to your doctors, talk to as many people as you can to decide. But before that, look into your own homes, your own desires and wishes, and then take a call. One last question from Neeraj. Single child will be happy without sibling? Neeraj, yes, they can. Yes, they can. It is about connecting with emotions. Today, don't we know about families where siblings are fighting with each other? There's no guarantee that only a sibling will take care of the other sibling. It could be the connect. Yes, it is true somewhere because of the conditions we have that we feel more close and they know us the best because they know us from childhood, that siblings are one of the closest people you have. But it is not true that they will be only happy with the children, with a sibling. So having a sibling is completely a mindset we have. I have known parents who have only one child and they're absolutely okay because for them, their friends mean the world. There is somebody in the cousins who they are, you know, they are close to. Their cousins know them more than probably their sibling would have. There are people whose cousins know them better than their siblings do. But it's a choice you will make. But if I really have to answer this question in yes or no, single child can be happy without the sibling. So don't let this be a reason to have a second child. Yeah. So it becomes that you focused only on your first and your second reason is because of your first. Have the second because you want to have the second. Okay. So look into the matter, look into the factors, look into the pointers and make a decision as an individual, as a couple, completely educated and empowered, and then go in for your number of children you want to have. We've spoken more about the urban cities today, but I know for a fact where we are looking into the towns and villages, and they're absolutely empowered, they're absolutely ready for more than three and four children, and they're having it. They have the support, they've taken the decision. Most of the decision might not be an educated decision, but that's how their lives are and they are okay with it. So it's okay to go in for whatever you have accepted for yourself. At times you need people and sibling who can help. Absolutely, Neeraj. You definitely need people to help. But as I'm saying, it may not be your sibling all the time. So having a sibling and then looking into constantly making them feel for each other, bond with each other. It's something that you are carrying in your mind. Cousins can be there, friends can be there. There will be people in your life who will be there for you, right? So look into it. And if you believe strongly that siblings are the people, then you should go for the second child and the third child and the fourth if you can afford and if you are, you know, can take it forward from there. As I mentioned in the earlier, you know, while I was talking, that I wanted to have four. I have two. So it's a decision you make, and, you know, as you'll have the first child, you'll know whether you want a second, and as you'll have the second, you will know whether you want the third. So, but just make sure that your age and your health and all the other factors are taken into consideration, and it's not just one thought that is driving you. And as a couple, you need to decide whether you both are in for this number of children or not. Okay. So thank you so much for watching me online today, being here on a Sunday morning for a very important topic of how many children to have. Thank you, everybody. I hope I've answered. In case you still have questions, please reach out to me through Arena, and I will be there to reply to you. And see you next week on a Saturday with another topic at 9:30. Thank you, guys. Thank you for being here on a Sunday morning. And remember the GOQii.